I haven't posted a video in a while, and I thought that I'd give you a long look at a slow mover. I shot this video from my deck using my Psionics Aurora night vision camera at 15 frames per second. The video was shot several months ago. It shows many of the characteristics of the UAP UFOs that I see in the night sky. The thing that makes this sequence special is that we can see the object for several minutes, and during that time, it changes its appearance many times. Be aware that this object is not visible to the unaided eye. When I look intently into the sky, I saw nothing. The object may be visible only in the infrared, or since it's only visible when it flashes, it may be just very hard to see. The object appears in the constellation Draco. At first, it's a dim white in color and flashing into view every few seconds. Then, the object changes its appearance. At first, a dull white ball. In the next flash, it has become a dull red ball. I paused the video on the frame where for 2/15 of a second, it shows as a dull red sphere. Then, suddenly, it becomes a brilliant white triangle, brighter than any of the other stars in the sky, but for only less than a tenth of a second. Once again, I've paused the video to allow you to get a good look at it in its triangle form. Note that it looks a bit yellow here, but I suspect that that's false color added by the camera to indicate that the object is radiating in the infrared spectrum. It's moving very slowly from the left to the right in the camera's view. You may be tempted to classify it as a satellite of some kind, but it's moving much too slowly to be in orbit. Here's another view of it moments later, when it shows itself as a brilliant, pure white triangle. Notice how bright the triangle is. It's much brighter than any of the other stars in the sky. For the next several minutes, the object continues to slowly make its way across this patch of sky, unnoticed by anyone, but right above their heads. These objects are in the sky above our heads all the time, day and night. We don't see them because they're hard to see, especially with the naked eye, and also because we don't look. So what are they? Well, for many reasons that I've covered before, they're not airplanes, or helicopters, or drones, or satellites. Their behavior is very odd. They do not comply with aviation regulations, and they do not show on radar. Are they made by humans? Maybe, but probably not. I have long ago accepted the fact that there are spacecraft in our sky that were not produced by us. What are they doing? Well, it's hard to say, but since there's plenty of historical proof that they've been there for millennia, it's unlikely that they are a threat to us. I'm one of those that believes that the answers to these questions will be forthcoming in the near future, and I do look forward to that day.